So students, today we are going to read the chapter number 9, The Bond of Love, which is written by Kenneth Anderson. He was an Indian-born British writer and hunter who wrote books about his adventures in the jungles of South India. So Kenneth Anderson's style of writing is descriptive as he talks about his adventures with wild animals. While most stories are about hunting tigers and leopards, particularly man-eaters, he includes chapters on his first-hand encounters with elephants, bison, and bears too. There are stories about less popular creatures like Indian wild dogs, hyenas, and snakes. So in his stories, he explains the habits and personalities of these animals. Now the story, Bond of Love, that we are going to read is the story of love and friendship between an animal and a human being. Kenneth Anderson gives a beautiful description of how a baby sloth bear receives care and love from a woman and so finds itself attached to her beyond its nature to do so. Now, bears, they are wild animals, so it is difficult for them to get attached to people. But here we see how that when the bear received love from a woman, then he got attached to her beyond its nature to do so. And thus, there is a point in the story where we find that the bear cannot bear the separation from its benefactor, that is the woman who takes care of her, and expresses its delight when it is reunited with her. Thus, the author comments that even animals, they show love and compassion. They reciprocate love and compassion, and they too can remember things like human beings. It is said that the wild animals, they forget things quickly. They don't remember the attachments, the compassion, the love because of their ferocious nature. But here he shows how that the wild animals, they can also remember things like human beings. Thus, the story written by Kenneth Anderson keeps the reader interested throughout. So let us begin reading the story. Now see, here the story, it begins with a question, the same question that can there be love and friendship between human beings and wild animals? So let's read the fascinating account of an orphan sloth bear. Orphan, jo sloth bear anath ho gaya tha because the mother died. The mother of the sloth bear died and this baby bear was rescued by the author, saved by the author. A brief information is also given here about the sloth bears. Let's first read that. Sloth bears inhabit forested areas, including the tropical rainforest of India and grasslands at lower elevations. Now, they inhabit means they live, they are found. Sloth bears are long, black, hairy animals. They are very large in size and they have large nose also. So these animals, they are found in the forested areas, especially the tropical areas, the tropical rainforest of India. Now you might have read in social science that how these tropical evergreen forests of India are found in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, the Western Ghats, then the coastline of peninsular India and most of the region of Assam and also in some parts of Odisha. So these wild animals, especially the sloth bear, it is found in the tropical rainforests and the forested areas. So sloth bears have very shaggy hair and long muzzles. So And yes, the grasslands at lower elevations, at lower heights, they are also found in the grassland areas. And the sloth bears, they have shaggy hair. Shaggy hair refers to tangled long hair and long muzzles. Muzzles refers to nose. They have projected nose. As you can see in this picture, that how they have a huge mouth. The nose area is projected towards front. So using their claws to dig, they can then use their lips to form a tube which can go deep into the ground or into hard to reach areas like dead trees for their food. their main food is termites. So they eat termites basically, and which is found in the dead trees in the jungle. So they can just use their lips in the form of a tube, and then they suck up those termites from the wood. So you can hear them suck up their food from several feet away. So they suck it up very noisily. You can hear them sucking up their foods from those trees. So let's start, begin the reading of this chapter. I will begin with Bruno, my wife's pet sloth bear. I got him for her by accident. So here I is the narrator, the writer himself, and he is talking about the Bruno, his pet, wife's pet, the sloth bear. And he says that he didn't purchase it from anywhere. He got it accidentally. 2 years ago, we were passing through the sugarcane fields near Mysore. So here V refers to the author and his friends. So they were passing through the sugarcane fields near Mysore. People were driving away the wild pigs from the fields by shooting at them. Now, as the narrator and his friends were passing through the sugarcane fields near Mysore, they saw some people. They were driving away the wild pigs from their fields by shooting at them. नाउ वो क्यों उन वाइल्ड पिग्स को दौड़ा रहे थे? क्योंकि वो जो वाइल्ड पिग्स हैं वो उनकी खेती बर्बाद करते थे, इसलिए इट वॉज इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट दोज पिग्स शुड बी ड्रिवन अवे, एंड दे यूज टू शूट एट देम फॉर ड्राइविंग देम अवे. एंड देन वॉट हैपन, वी थॉट दैट एवरीथिंग वॉज ओवर वेन सडनली अ ब्लैक स्लॉथ बेयर केम आउट पैंटिंग इन द हॉट सन. So as those farmers were driving away those wild pigs, some died, some escaped from there, and the author thought that now everything was over, but suddenly at that time a sloth bear came in front of their car. And narrator says that now I will not shoot a sloth bear wantonly. Wantonly means mercilessly for no good reason. So he says, I will not shoot a sloth bear. But unfortunately for the poor beast, one of my companions did not feel that way about it and promptly shot the bear on the spot. But he says that that one of narrator's companion shot at the bear as he did not feel the way author felt, and thus he shot it to save himself because in fear of getting attacked by this sloth bear. As we watched the fallen animal, we were surprised to see that the black fur on its back moved and left the prostrate body. Prostrate body here refers to the dead body of the bear, which was lying on the ground flat. So the narrator says that as the body was shot, as the bear was shot, it fell dead. And he says that they were surprised to see that something was moving on its back. The black fur on its back moved, something moved with from the dead body that was lying on the ground. Then we saw it was a baby bear that had been riding on its mother's back when the sudden shot had killed her. So when the narrator and its friend they went near the fallen animal, they saw that a bear cub was riding on the mother's back. And the writer said that the little creature ran around its prostrate parent, making a pitiful noise. The bear cub, it was scared and it was making pitiful howls, pitiful cries. The bear was crying there and running around its dead mother. I ran up to it to attempt a capture. It scooted into the sugarcane field. See the word scooted here. You have heard the word scooter. Scooter runs on vehicle and runs on the road. So here, scooter, this word scooted, it's the verb form which means ran away. So it scooted into the sugarcane field. So as the narrator attempted to catch that baby bear, it ran into the fields. Following it with my companions, I was at last able to grab it by the scruff of its neck. Scruff of its neck means the back of its neck, while it snapped and tried to scratch me with its long hooked claws. So the narrator says that they were able to catch the baby bear, But the baby bear tried to free itself. It tried to scratch the author with its long hooked claws, even bite him. Snapped him means he tried to bite him too. He says, we put it in one of the gunny bags we had brought, and when I got back to Bangalore, I duly presented it to my wife. So somehow the author and his friends, they managed to control it and put it into a gunny bag. Gunny bag कहते हैं जो जूट के bags होते हैं. So he put it into that bag and brought it to Bangalore. The author presented this creature to his wife. And he says, she was delighted. She at once put a colored ribbon around its neck. And after discovering the cub was a boy, she christened it Bruno. Christian matlab? Named the bear Bruno. So when the author's wife, she saw that the cub, the baby bear, she was extremely happy. Delighted means happy. And thus, she puts a color ribbon around its neck. So when you keep a pet, you just put a tag around his neck. And thus, she also puts a ribbon around its neck, showing that it was their pet. And when they came to know that the young cub was a boy, she named the boy, the cub as Bruno. The author says Bruno soon took to drinking milk from a bottle. So the author's wife, she brought up Bruno with love and care, and thus she looked after the bear cub as if it was her own child. And at first Bruno was taught to drink milk with a bottle. Jaise hum chote bacche ko bottle se milk pilate hain, so Bruno also started drinking milk from a bottle. It was but a step further, and within a few days, he started eating and drinking everything else. Now, within a few days, Bruno started eating things normally. And the author says that he drank and ate everything. Bruno jo tha, lagbhag sab kuch kha leta tha. And everything is the right word. He said everything. That means he gives an example. He says, for because he ate porridge. Porridge कहते हैं दलिया. Porridge made from any ingredients, vegetable, fruit, nuts, meat especially pork, curry and rice, regardless of condiments. Condiments कहते हैं spices. किसी भी तरह के spices डाले हो, he would eat those things. Then chilies, bread, eggs, chocolates, sweets, pudding, ice cream, etc., etc., etc. तो जब खाने की बात आती है, this bear could eat everything. As for drink, he would drink milk, tea, coffee, lime juice, aerated water. Aerated means the fizzy drinks, the carbonated drinks, and buttermilk, even beer and alcoholic liquor, and in fact, anything liquid. So the author says that he could eat and drink anything. It all went down with relish. So he used to enjoy everything to fill his stomach. And this author now here shares an incident also. But before that, he mentions, the bear became very attached to our two Alsatian dogs and to all the children of the tenants living in our bungalow. So this bear was very attached to everyone in the family, the husband, that is the author, and his wife. And then he was also very friendly with the two Alsatian dogs. Alsatian is a breed of dog. So he was very, very friendly with those dogs and to all the children of the tenants. Tenants कहते हैं जो किराएदार उनके घरों में रह रहे थे. So the bear was very friendly with those children too. He was left quite free in his younger days and spent his time in playing, running into the kitchen and going to sleep in our beds. So the author says that he became attached to all the children of the tenant living in the bungalow. And he spent time in playing, running into the kitchen and going to sleep in the beds of the author and his wife. So because of the love and affection shown by the author's wife, he developed great affection for her. One day an accident befell him. So an accident actually happened to him. Befell him means happened to him, occurred to him. I put down poison, barium carbonate, to kill the rats and mice that had got into my library. So an unfortunate accident happened, and as there were rats in the author's library, And in order to kill them, he had put down barium carbonate. It's a kind of salt which is poison. So he put this in the library. Bruno entered library as he often did, and he ate some of the poison. So Bruno, he used to quite often go to the library, and when he entered the library, he ate the poison there. Paralysis set in to extent that he could not stand on his feet. So because of that poison, he suffered from a stroke of paralysis. Wo hil dul nahi pa raha tha. But he dragged himself on his stumps to my wife, who called me. Somehow, Bruno managed to reach author's wife. He slowly dragged himself towards the author's wife. He was weakening rapidly. The wife, she immediately called the author. I guessed what had happened, and the author, he understood immediately what had happened. Off I rushed in the car to Vet's residence. Vet's resident means the doctors who treat animal, veterinary doctor. A case of poisoning tame bear, barium carbonate, what to do? So it was quite difficult for the doctor also, because this bear, Bruno, was a wild bear who had taken the poison, eaten this poison accidentally. And what to do? How to treat this wild bear who has this poison? Out came his medical books, and a feverish reference to index began. So he brought all the medical books that he had. He started looking in. He started with an intense search, referring to the index of the book, and he began looking for the correct medicine. And he said, "What poison did you say, sir? Barium carbonate. Ah, yes, Baba, barium salts. Ah, barium carbonate. Symptoms, paralysis, treatment, injections of. Just a minute, sir. I'll bring my syringe and the medicine." So the doctor took some time to find out what was the correct treatment to be given to a bear which was tamed by the author. So he had to look for the books, search intensely in the books what could be the correct treatment for this kind of poison. And then he went to bring the syringe and the medicine. A dash back to car, Bruno still floundering about on his stumps, but clearly weakening rapidly. So the author's attention went back to the car, where he found the Bruno. He was still floundering. He was still struggling to move about his stumps, but he was weakening very fast. He vomited also, with heavy breathing, with heavy flanks and gaping mouth. So Bruno's condition was actually degrading at that moment. And the author at once took him to the doctor. He brought him out of the car. He was found breathing very heavily with mouth open. "Hold him, everybody. In goes the hypodermic." Hypodermic refers to a long needle used in the syringe, right, to give injections. So he asked everyone to hold Bruno, because he knew that this animal would definitely react intensely. And Bruno squeals. Bruno, he screamed loudly. 10 cc of the antidote enters the system without a drop being wasted. The doctor was very careful while injecting, and he successfully injected the medicine into the body of Bruno. 10 minutes later, condition unchanged. After the antidote was given, there was no change in the condition of Bruno. And that's why the doctor, he decided to give another 10 cc of injection. So another 10 cc injected. 10 minutes later, breathing less stertorous. Stertorous refers to means the noisy breathing was now reduced, and Bruno can move his arms and legs a little, although he cannot stand yet. So now the condition improved, and Bruno got up. Somehow he was still struggling to stand properly, but it was better than before. 30 minutes later, Bruno gets up and has a great feed. And after 30 minutes, the condition was actually improved. And here we find Bruno again eating his meal, and he enjoyed a big meal there. He looks at us disdainfully. Disdainfully means in anger, as much as to say, "What's a barium carbonate to a big black bear like me?" Bruno is still eating. So the bear, it actually as if it seemed that when he saw the author, the look that was in his eyes, as if the bear was trying to tell that what a barium carbonate can do to him, it could not harm it. And thus we find that Bruno is still having his full meal, eating lavishly, enjoying his meal. Here he also shares another incident. Another time, he found nearly 1 gallon of engine oil, old engine oil, which I had drained from the sump of the stud baker. Sump of the stud baker means from the oil tank of stud baker. It is an old American car and was keeping as a weapon against the inroads of termites. So there were termites in the house of the author, and he wanted to destroy all those termites. So he had taken out the engine oil so that he can use it against termites. And what did Bruno do? He promptly drank the lot, but luckily it had no ill effects whatever. So the narrator shares another occasion, and he says that on another occasion, the little bear drank a lot of engine oil, but fortunately, it had no effect on him. So here we see that these two examples actually justify the narrator's comment that how Bruno ate and drank everything. But luckily, he was saved by the poison attack, and then also when he had taken eat, we can say when he drank the old engine oil, luckily nothing happened to him. So, dear students, this is for today. We will meet in the next class and continue reading the chapter. Have a nice day.